introduction. I am not a teacher, but am a awakener. Ladies and gentlemen, let me share with you a great story, a great pericope, which describes a relationship between a teacher and a student. Mrs. Thompson, teacher, enters her class and says, "Love you all." She knows she is lying because she is indifferent towards one child named Teddy. He's not social, he's neither interested in studies nor sports. During the first semester marks, Mrs. Thompson writes in his report card in the remarks section for Teddy, "Not a bright student, needs improvement." When the marks card goes to the headmistress to sign, they were shocked. They contacted Mrs. Thompson and asked why this remark. She told her reason that she doesn't like the child. They show her Teddy's previous marks cards, and it was written the brightest student of the class. Mrs. Thompson also learned that his mother had passed away because of cancer, and it was beginning up to show up in his performance. Mrs. Thompson broke down into tears. Thereafter, she worked on Teddy and helped him in whichever way possible. On the Christmas Eve, many students gifted Mrs. Thompson various gifts in shiny wrappers. There was one gift wrapped up in a newspaper. She knew it was from Teddy. She opened it. There was a half-used perfume bottle and a bracelet from which few stones had already fallen. She wore it immediately, wore the perfume and the bracelet. Teddy was glad. And he told her, "Ma'am, now you smell like my mother." Few years later, Teddy, now Dr. Theodore, PhD, contacted Mrs. Thompson and sent a letter to her. "Ma'am, there are many people I've met in life, but you are the best person I've ever met. I invite you to my wedding." And along with the letter, there was an attached ticket, to and fro tickets. Mrs. Thompson attended the wedding, and the volunteers made sure that she gets the front row seat with a placard written, "Mother." Theodore introduced Mrs. Thompson to his newly wedded wife, and he then said, "Ma'am, without you, I wouldn't have realized my dreams and come this far." Mrs. Thompson broke down and said, "My dear, without you, I wouldn't have realized that a teacher must become first a parent to all his students and then only a teacher." Friends, I believe there is a Theodore in everybody's life, and you can be that Mrs. Thompson or Mr. Vigneshwar in Rajdeep Sir's case, to be a turning point in their lives, so that you can say that I have the best mentee, and they can say I have the best mentor. And yes, I do have the best mentor, distinguished Toastmaster Rajdeep Manwani, who does the unbelievable, touches lives of everyone he meets, gives hope to everyone, inspires so many lives. But all this couldn't have happened if I hadn't joined Toastmasters, which was founded by Sir Ralph C. Smedley in 1924 in Santa Ana, California. Today, Toastmasters runs 14,350 clubs in 122 countries with 2,92,000 members. So let me brief you with the meeting and its sessions. The meeting consists of three sessions. The first session is the prepared speeches round, where members come up on stage, give their prepared speeches according to the manuals designed by the Toastmasters International. The second session is the table topic session, which is the most interesting session, where members and guests are asked to come up on stage, speak on one one topic for 1 or 2 minutes on the spot. The third session is the evaluation round, where the whole meeting is evaluated by the general evaluator and the prepared speeches by the respective evaluators. Now, the general evaluator for today is the living legend of Bangalore Toastmasters Club. The founder member of Bangalore Toastmasters Club, exceptional speaker, great motivator, and a humble personality. It is a great honor for me to introduce him. Please kindly welcome the general evaluator for today, Toastmaster Robinson D'Souza.